All right, so what is up, creatives? This is Tom, welcome back to another video. So I've been editing now on Final Cut Pro for a little over a year. So I thought I would kind of break down my experiences as a professional video editor, someone who edits video or makes videos for a living. I wanna break down why I think the benefits of Final Cut Pro definitely outweigh the negatives, and basically sort of compare it to, I guess, the other sort of mainstream editor for sort of internet videos, online content, which is of course Adobe Premiere Pro. Now I want to make it clear that I'm especially definitely not bashing Premiere Pro. I think that it is a fantastic and elite editor if that's kind of your bag. I know I sort of jab fun at the performance obviously in the intro that I just shared there, but I do think it's a fantastic choice, a very, very powerful editor, if you have the machine to drive it. But as I say, personally, I am really happy with the move that I made to Final Cut Pro. So I want to share some of my thoughts, experiences, and also some tips to, I guess, almost like improve your Final Cut workflow. And again, of course, this advice comes from a Mac user. This is basically a video if you own a Mac or are mainly editing on a Mac. If you're on a Windows machine, well, don't really know why you're watching this video, because Final Cut Pro is obviously a Mac only system. If you're on Windows, probably just go with Final Cut. Speed and performance is by far and away the most important feature for me for Final Cut Pro. Or it's not a sort of feature per se, but just the speed, reliability, and just general overall performance of Final Cut compared to Premiere Pro is just leaps and bounds ahead for me. When I was using Premiere, I was getting constant crashes, couldn't work in a 4K timeline. It was just basically impossible for me to edit 4K video and watch back my content without using proxies. Proxies are fine, and I end up using proxies sometimes when I'm working with footage from my Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera, but on the whole, I can drop 4K footage into Final Cut on my 2016 MacBook Pro and edit content in the timeline extremely, extremely efficiently. Again, as someone who makes online content and also content for clients for my living, this is basically just so valuable. I can just edit and not have to worry about the performance. Speeds are just way faster than Premiere Pro when I was using that as my main editor. So yeah, basically I have just yet to use an editor which just matches Final Cut in its performance. It's actually probably worth noting here that I'm not really gonna be talking about DaVinci Resolve. I know that if you are maybe looking for a free editor, that is probably a fantastic choice. I just personally haven't played around with it. However, I have heard it is a fantastic choice, especially if you're looking for something free. There we go, that's sort of my main reason. Everything apart from this is almost like superfluous, because that speed and reliability is just central to me as a video freelancer. I need to know that my editor is quick, powerful, and is not going to let me down. Next up on the list is organization. Now, I never thought that I would be saying this, but after a year of using Final Cut, the way that Final Cut sort of handles its files has actually just had me coming around to it. So I like the way that Final Cut does this. You have libraries at the top, you have events, and then you have projects. So all of those things sit inside each other. It's worth noting here that I do have a tip to make basically Final Cut behave a little bit closer to Premiere Pro in the way that it handles media. I don't personally like the way that Final Cut copies almost every file inside the library. It just makes the storage an absolute nightmare, and I just do not recommend that you use this workflow. So to combat that, just go into your preferences, go into the settings, change the media handling to leave in place. That will basically mean that all of your files are referenced in the correct place. If you're organized with your files within your file system, there's no need to duplicate everything across and basically create two files for every single shot on your system. Quite useful if you're editing with multiple people involved, but if you're just on your own, absolutely no need to do that. So I do recommend that you do that. But again, the way that Final Cut handles these files, I just absolutely love. My sort of default configuration is that I create a new library for every single project that I'm working on. Then I create events either for multiple days if the projects have had multiple days shoots, or multiple cameras if I've used multiple cameras on those shoots. So it's actually a really efficient way of organizing your files. And then of course you create a project in one of those events for your main piece of creative. Again, compared to Premiere Pro and the sort of projects and then bins within those projects, I just find that actually the Final Cut's way of organizing it is actually much more logical. And again, I didn't think that that was going to be the case, but after using it for a year or so, I really come round to Final Cut's organizational system. All right, magnetic timeline. Here's another thing that I just did not think I was going to come round to. As someone who has edited on Premiere Pro for sort of 7-8 years before switching to Final Cut, I wanted the sort of out of order, out of chronological order. I wanted to be able to edit a segment, leave it on the side of my timeline, and then come back to it later and maybe drag it into the over the other side. However, with Final Cut, you can't really do that, or at least not in the default way the system is set up. So everything snaps to the left. It is a magnetic timeline. Things will sort of automatically pull to the left. Now, for an internet video editor, this is fantastic. It saves you so much time. You don't have to sort of go in and delete every single additional piece of snippet in between. You can get very efficient with how you edit. Cut, delete, everything snaps to the left. Cut, delete, everything snaps to the left. Again, there are times where sometimes you don't want to edit in this way and you want to just be able to out of chronological order, you can basically just bump up your whole timeline, lift it from the storyline, and then your editor will behave like Premiere Pro in that sort of out of order, allowing you to create a bunch of content over to the right and then maybe drag it over to the left. So you basically get a win-win in terms of the magnetic timeline. Let me get to a real bonus for, again, video freelancers, independent creators, is that Final Cut is a one-time off purchase. It's obviously a little bit more expensive than Premiere Pro, but if you sort of spread that out over the cost of a year, Premiere Pro is over double in terms of pricing. Final Cut Pro will run you $299, and again, it is a one-off purchase. Once you have purchased it, you never have to purchase it again, and you will get every single update for free. Personally, I do not see how Adobe is still in the game of monthly subscription. That subscription is expensive. It's one thing for professionals, but for casual users, that adds up. I just also want to share a couple of sort of final thoughts around improving Final Cut as an editor. My first tip is to turn off background render. Unless you're on a really, really swanky, fast Mac, background render is going to really slow down your workflow. That's just a really simple change. Just go into preferences, go into rendering, and turn off background render. Again, your computer will thank you later. It basically just means that you can render your project once you're done, or selectively render sections of your project if you want to see them in sort of closer to real-time playback. Just trust me, try editing without background render on and you will thank me later. And the next is a tip that I've been using for a little while now. I used to use it particularly with music because it means you could swap out a music track very easily, but actually I've discovered that it's actually quite useful for video clips as well. That is to create a compound clip for a large piece of content, a large clip in your editor, and then any changes that you make to that compound clip will sort of propagate throughout your entire project. If that's color correction, scale, or movement of the clip itself. Basically, just creating that compound clip almost like nests it a bit like they use in Final Cut Pro, or excuse me, Premiere Pro, and basically all of those changes will just propagate. So it's a super quick, efficient way of making sure that everything in your project is cohesive and you don't miss any clips in terms of color correction, etc. There we have it, guys. Those are just some thoughts in terms of Final Cut Pro or editing from a Final Cut Pro perspective compared to Premiere Pro. Now, again, I don't want this to be a sort of a hard and fast rule for anyone. If you have an editor that you like to use, absolutely go for it. These are just my experiences as someone who used Premiere Pro for a long time and then moved to Final Cut Pro. I've just found that the performance and the experience as a whole is just way more suited to the Mac ecosystem. And I think it shows. If you haven't tried Final Cut, definitely check out the trial. There's a 14-day trial if you haven't had any experience with it. Give it a download and hopefully you do enjoy it. If you have any questions, just drop a comment down below. Subscribe if you'd like to see more video content just like this, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Yo, what's up, guys? So I just realized I was tearing through this edit in Final Cut Pro 10, as you'd expect with such a fast editor. But I realized that I hadn't mentioned anything about After Effects integration. So this is quite an important thing for me, and obviously for lots of video editors, is the integration between Premiere Pro and After Effects. Now, personally, I'm absolutely fine doing my work in After Effects and then just exporting out and importing that clip into Final Cut Pro. I personally haven't transitioned over to Motion just because I've been using After Effects for so many years now to feel very comfortable within that system. However, if you do an absolutely ton of work in After Effects and want that integration with Premiere Pro, then absolutely you do need to take that into consideration. Maybe staying on Premiere is the best solution for you.